My name is Candy Jacobs. I'm from Tegelen. It's a city in the Netherlands. And I've been skating since I was 13 years old. I started out of boredom, really. We had a skateboard lying around, and my mom was like, go do something, because I was driving her crazy, because I'm a little bit hyperactive. And she was like, you know what? I'm gonna take you to the skate park and pick you up in 2 hours. And I fell in love. I never stopped. That's a hard question. My home spot is really LA. That's the spot where I feel most at home. But when I'm in Holland, I skate in Valhalla skate park a lot. Skate in Didam. I skate a lot of skate parks. I don't really skate street in Holland that much. When I go to the States, my friends live there, and then we visit all the good spots like Jaekwon and like, everything really. But my favorite park is the Barracks. Because that was like a legendary thing for me to be there. And then, Steve was like, hey, you're welcome anytime to come over, so. Skateboarding feels like the ultimate freedom. I think skateboarding for me is the, because I'm so active and my mind is always racing kind of, when I skate, it's quiet, it's just me and my skateboard. And that for me is the ultimate freedom, I think. It was a while since I've been there. I was there the first 4 years, I think, and then I didn't go for 2 years because of other contests. So I felt like kind of awkward going again because it was so long that I had been there. But I just wanted to skate the park, see what happened. Like I never go to win or whatever. I just go to skate a good run and then hopefully do my best. And in the beginning, I didn't like it because it was a little bit slippery for my wheels. So I was like, oh, I know, it's so slick and I can't skate. But I have that at every park I go to, like the first maybe hour, I'm like, I can't do anything. And then once it started rolling, it felt really good. And I was like, okay, let's do this. Yeah, I was blown away by how many girls there were, but also how high the level was. Because I remember going there the first time, and I think we were with 7 girls, and I think 4 of us could only do like an ollie and maybe a board slide, and now the level was insane. Like we had I think Kate was the youngest one, she's 12, and then we had Alexis, who was the oldest one, I think she's 30, 31, something like that. And for me to see that the level is so high on all these age groups, it's insane. I was really blown away and super impressed. Well, when you qualify first, it's always like, damn, I could do this, like I could actually win this event. But it's also, the pressure is a little bit more on because you're already in the top spot, so you can only go down. So for me, that's always a little bit of a sketchy spot. I'd rather be like come in second or third in the qualifications, knowing if I step it up a little bit, I could get first. But I was like, if I skate this run again and do well, then I might make top 3. And once I skated my run, I was like, okay, I think I have like top 2. I wasn't sure if I got first because I thought Haley was really good and she came in fourth. I was kind of surprised, but I was like, ooh, she might take the victory. But I was stoked, yeah. This was my first time going to Brazil, and I was a little bit scared of going because I heard all the stories about getting robbed and people are super sketchy. And then I arrived and it was nothing like I thought it would be. The people were really nice, and I made some new friends, and I already have friends through Facebook and stuff over there, so we kind of had a crew. And it was my first time skating there. It was really hot, but the park was cool, the people were really nice, and the organization was awesome. Well, it was kind of a weird thing how I got involved. I was in the States for just skating, and I was going to Woodward Camp, and then someone hit me up on Instagram saying, hey, I sent you a direct message, check it out. I didn't even know what a direct message was, so I was like, what are they saying? I checked it out, and then Monique O'Toole and Eric Sandoval sent me a message, and they were like, hey, we heard you're in the States, we don't really know who you are, but we want to skate with you. Are you down to go street skating? That was one of my big dreams, to street skate in LA, but I didn't have a car, I didn't know the spots, so that for me was a perfect opportunity. And I went there, we only filmed for 3 days, and then I had like 1.5 minutes, I think. So it was like super exciting. You're like, whoa, it's insane that you already have 1.5 minutes. But then I wanted more. So half a year later, I came back and I stayed for another 3 weeks. finished my part and then went to a contest, broke my knee. So that was perfect timing, actually. Like, I finished my part and then it was done. And well, ever since I came out, like, a lot happened. I think I really decided not to skate too many contests anymore before that, because I was like, okay, now I'm gonna do, like, I'm gonna try to film a street part, I'm gonna do, like, go to Woodward camp, go on a tour, like, do fun stuff. But contest skating for me is really fun. So they were like, dude, you should just skate contests again. I got my invitation for the X Games again after they heard I was filming the Quit Your Day Job, because that's what they were missing before when I got cut from the X Games. So it, like, oh no, oh no, oh no, no! Damn it, Julia. Just spraying little kids. No, and like, a lot happened after that. A lot of people gave me good reactions, but also I think my skateboarding got a new boost and I started skating contests again, and now I'm second on the world ranking, I think. So a lot of good stuff happened, for sure. Well, I think the Olympics is going to change skateboarding overall, but in a good kind of way. I think it will make skateboarding way more accessible, and for me, what I said, like, skateboarding is my biggest freedom, and if more people can experience that, that would be, that's the main goal, I think. And the level is going to go up. It's already happening. I don't think it's because of the Olympics, but I see, for example, Mariah Duran doing hard flip back lips. I see Jen Soto doing heel flip front boards, stuff like that. That's next level stuff, and I'm really excited to see that. But I think the Olympics is only going to spark that a little bit more. It's going to be a good thing. Not yet. Yeah, I'm going to try to film another street part. But I have to see, because right now I'm depending on prize money to earn my income. And if I get injured, that means I can't skate contests. And street skating is still a little bit more risky than skating in a skate park. So if my sponsors are willing to back me, then I'm definitely filming another street park. And hopefully not get injured, but then at least I can take the risk to do that again. Yeah, I got involved with Dan Gorilla, like, I think 1.5 years, 2 years ago maybe, because I was telling my story about skating contests, and the owner or like the owner of the German Dan Gorilla is Toby Albatross, and he's one of the first pro skaters in Germany. So I was like super impressed that he wanted to work together with me, and then he said, you know what, I'm gonna give you a phone call around summer, and then you can join the project. And the project is about making kids aware about a healthy lifestyle, taking care of themselves, like, body-wise, so they learn sports, freestyle sports. So it's hacky sack, freestyle soccer, breakdance, parkour, and skateboarding. That those are the sports that they can try. You don't have to be involved with an association or like whatever. You can do it on your own. You can get your skateboard and skate outside somewhere. You don't need to be pay contribution. So that's what they're trying to show them. But it's also about eating healthy. So for them, it's really a good thing to see what can happen, what can spiral from all this positive energy, and then living healthy. So they get to experience that for one day. So maybe they can put it in their lives, like, try to do that more, or talk to their parents and say, hey, maybe we can eat hummus today or whatever. So it was a really fulfilling project, because we also worked with a lot of people who came from Syria or like fled their country to come to Germany, people with kids with disabilities, and it's all kids between, I think, 10 and 24, anywhere in between. So it's really good to see how that affects people, and I'm super stoked that I have to do that project. Sponsors! Now, honestly, I think the girls who are skateboarding right now are really are already on a really professional level, but the companies who back them aren't on that level yet. So I think it's definitely necessary. It's not really sponsor-wise, but just for contests and companies to take them serious as well. Because I know there's still a lot of discussion going on about female and male prize money, sponsors for females, and a lot of dudes say it's not fair because the level's not as high, but does that mean we're not working as hard, you know, stuff like that. And I think if the companies or the media decides to take that serious, then everything else is going to happen as well. So I think there's a lot of, to get it, make it more professional, we definitely need more media exposure. And for example, if you have like an H&M ad or whatever with a girl skating, make sure it's like an actual skateboarder, stuff like that. It could help so much. I'm doing everything to be able to skate. It's not even I train like three days a week with a personal trainer when I'm not in contest season, kind of. I skate every day, and I try to develop all the time. I try to try new tricks, skate with different people, so I get to see like different influences, and I just skate my ass off. Really, that's what I'm mostly doing. And honestly, it's the best decision I ever made, just to do like to go for full on skateboarding, and I hope I can do it for a while. I have a lot of contests going on. Like the next, I think every weekend I'm in a different country for a different contest. And then I think my last contest is in Montreal. And after that, I'm planning on going to the States to get some filming done, hang out with my friends as well who skate there, and get some new tricks maybe. So I think, but for now it's just contest. Skateboarding gives me everything. Honestly, it's the, I was talking to my dad yesterday, and we're like, dude, it feels like we're both retired, because I get to do what I love the most all the time. And of course, like, it's not always fun because you fall and you get injuries and stuff like that. But for me, it's the biggest sense of freedom to be able to skate like all the time, do what makes me happy, and meet all these awesome people. I've visited countries that people will never visit in their lives just because it doesn't come across their path. And I just shred hard, let the good times roll. I think that's, honestly, it's all about fun. As long as you have fun in what you do, then you're doing well, I think. So it doesn't matter what level you're on or what level you're not on. But I think as long as you enjoy it, you always do stuff that makes you happy. And if that's skateboarding, then for sure do it, because I can recommend it to everyone.